May you always lead from the leading in your chest. May you be treated like you be treated as guests. May you get your rest, may you catch your breath. May you catch your breath. May the best of your today be the worst of your tomorrow.
feel surrounded. Gotta get your feet, gotta get your feet, keep grounded. Keep grounded inside your ears, just like the way it sounded. And just say whatever, cause there was no way you're grounded.
Thank you.
better day despite the challenge. All you gotta do is leave it better than you found it. It's gonna game you, hold your balance. I just say whatever, cause there is no way yours, there is no way yours.
You all look really good. I'm just really good. I'm just saying, did you agree? This group looks really, really good.
Really, really good.
Even better without masks.
Even better without masks.
Wonderful.
You look wonderful.
We are.
How thankful we are.
Please be seated.
Please be seated.
Graduates.
Graduates.
Parents.
Family
and friends, Board of Trustees,
Board of Trustees,
and all of the Calvin community watching online,
welcome
to the Calvin Christian School commencement ceremony
for
the class of 2020-21. This is truly an
evening of celebration.
And I'm sad.
And I'm sad,
very sad to
I'm
report
very sad
that our new upper school principal,
Mr. Illman,
would have loved to be here doing this very part, is very ill tonight.
So be
thinking about him and praying
so
for him.
We
miss him.
And all the Lord's blessings on him.
I'd like to right now, please,
would you join me in welcoming Ms. Deb Boonstra, teacher emeritus, as of yesterday.
Who will open our ceremony?
Who will open our ceremony in prayer?
Now I have to change all my stationery. Will you pray with me? Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father, we pause now.
And it is good for us to do so.
We need your calm in the midst of our chaos.
So we come to you, Almighty God,
to say that we are so thankful that our times are in your hands.
At the end of an improbable year, Students and teachers in close enough proximity to learn together effectively and well, we pause to thank you for your presence here on campus and for good leaders that have led us to this place. As we shine a spotlight on these graduates here tonight, we honor you in the same way that displaying a masterpiece of fine art honors the artist. They are your workmanship, created with gifts that enable each of them to praise you uniquely and well. We thank you for the joy that they have brought us. We thank you for each personality and their good character. We thank you for their faith and their examples of godliness. It is our temptation as teachers and families and friends to ask that these graduates may have safe and happy lives free from harm and worry.
And we think we know what that should look like.
However, your word tells us that a rewarding life of discipleship does not always match our ideas of the good life. Instead, we pray that you will take each of these graduates, precious children of yours, and continue to equip them for lives of discipleship. Guide them as they find their places in your kingdom. Through your spirit, enable them to be salt and light in this world. Draw them to yourself as they face temptations. Be near to them when the complexities of life would overwhelm them. Use them as you have designed them, and always may your name be praised.
For this program here, please speak to us through the words that have been prepared for us to hear.
Please clear heads, calm nerves, and bless us all on this very happy occasion. In Christ's name, amen.
Thank you, Ms. B. Now, would you please join me in welcoming the class of 2021 salutatorian, Joshua Yu, who will give the salutatory address.
Good evening, parents, teachers, family and friends, and my fellow graduates. My name is Joshua Yu, and it is my honor to be standing here today as salutatorian of the class of 2021. As I begin, I must say, this speech was a bit of a puzzler to begin writing. It's the custom of the salutatorian to look back on their high school years. I was scratching my head trying to figure out what to do about the fact that I came here last year. Yet, as I chewed through the thought some more, the gravity of the situation hit me. I only came here last year. My experience has been rich enough to fill up a lifetime of memories. I thought I'd relate to everyone some of the big picture highlights. Let me begin with the teachers. The great thing about a tight-knit Christian community like Calvin is that the teachers serve as an integral part of our ethical and social lives, in addition to our academics. I'd like to personally thank all of the teachers I've had for their invaluable contributions. I think we would all agree that Mr. Whitener is one of the most hilarious teachers at Calvin. In addition to his humor, his dedication to upholding a Christian worldview in world events, both past and present, is admirable. Miss B is one of the best math teachers I've ever had. She teaches with a surgical precision. Through her class, I've absorbed an insane amount of information and also sharpened my work ethic. Mrs. Lundgren is the resident millennial. Her relatability to us unruly teenagers has made her English classes incredibly entertaining, informative, and memorable. Mr. Marriott is such a kind soul. His steady, patient guidance in our spiritual lives has been of immeasurable worth, and he is a great friend to everyone in his classes. Senora Garcia has exhibited tremendous resolve and a motherly touch in taming and teaching my anatomy class, and is also spreading the riches of a multicultural heritage. Dr. Spivak has been a great intellect and mentor. As many of you know, he has aided immeasurably in getting the ping pong club and culture off the ground at Calvin. Mr. Baker is grounded yet mischievous. His patient teaching and sarcastic humor have made his classes very rewarding and entertaining. Mr. Miedema has done a great job at physical education. At a personal level, I also appreciate his care for the international students at Calvin. Mr. Seaman is an incredible music teacher. His knowledge of the craft is admirable, and his constant positivity instills a love of music in every student. Mr. Deist, I'm sure, has saved a ton of us from all sorts of trouble, in school and out of school. He is incredibly kind and understanding. Dr. Pepper will be sorely missed. For the confused parents, Dr. Pepper is our resident therapy bunny. In addition to the teachers I have had, I must thank the rest of the teachers as well. I've not forgotten you guys. I've seen your positive influence on my classmates' lives, and I'm incredibly grateful for all you have contributed to the school. I would also like to thank the administration, the cleaning staff, the food staff, all the other unsung heroes. We appreciate your hard work behind the scenes to make the school a better place. Now, of course, no school community is complete without the students. The students here have made my experience at Calvin incredible. One of my earliest memories at Calvin was our time at retreat back in 2019. The first day there, one of the kids struck up a conversation with me in such a casual and familiar tone that I had to do a double take. Do I know this person? I asked, and it turns out, no, they just wanted to be friends with me. And hey, we've been really good friends ever since. This has just been a sliver of my social experience at Calvin. Everywhere I turn, I am greeted with a warm attitude and lasting kindness. I've made plenty of great memories, from late nights out in the Chicken Lease's parking lot to long, hectic days in preparation for school events. No matter the occasion, I always find myself gravitating towards Calvin to spend more time with the wonderful people who go here. I can think of one particularly extreme example. As some of you know, I live almost half an hour away from school, and I work somewhere even further. A couple months ago, I went to work from school, only to realize there is a school event in the evening. So I drove back without a second thought. I drove 100 miles total that day, just to spend a couple more hours with my friends. So think you guys are starting to get a feel for how much I love this place. I would also like to thank the parents of Calvin. Thank you for your generosity and dedication to the community. Thank you for providing the shoulders upon which my wonderful peers have stood on. I also have to thank my parents. There is no understating this. Without you guys, I would be nowhere. You guys came to America with nothing, but you have provided me with everything. All the material needs I could think of, all the support to go above and beyond in my academics and hobbies, and most importantly of all, the most incredible gift of a worldview rooted in the saving grace of Christ. I love you so much. I would run out of superlatives to describe how much I appreciate you. Okay, deep breath. Overall, I'm so thankful that my parents forced me to make the jump to Calvin. I've been blessed immeasurably through my time here. I think this place is a great example of biblical community, for as 1 Thessalonians 5:11 says, "Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing." I have certainly been built up. I hope all of you feel the same. Anyways, enough of my own thoughts. As the evening goes on, why don't we pump ourselves up to celebrate the dedication and character of some of this wonderful community I talked about. May God bless all their endeavors in the years to come. Thank you, everyone. Shishi Daja.
You somehow squeezed 12 years of life at Calvin into two. So bless your heart, Joshua. Thank you so much for that. So now we will welcome Faith Expression, who will sing the song, "The Lord Bless and Keep You," under the direction of Calvin's upper school music teacher, Mr. Daniel Seaman. Let's welcome them into their places. Graduates, did you catch that? That was a blessing. You just received a blessing. Isn't that special? Thank you, Faith Expression, Mr. S. Well done. In line with the final phrase of our mission statement, there is a Calvin Christian tradition in the annual commencement ceremony to recognize the lifelong service to Calvin Christian School of an individual or couple. Mr. Terry Cock will make the presentation by way of video, since it was not possible for all to be present this evening. So let's enjoy this presentation together.
Hello, Calvin community. I'm very pleased to be here with Klaus and Joan DeHaan, the 2021 recipients of the Service to Calvin Award. We have been giving this award to recognize people who have volunteered much over a long period of service to make Calvin what it is. We do this to not only recognize outstanding service to to Calvin Christian, but more importantly, to remind our students and our community that our God calls us to serve Him and also to serve others. Calvin's mission statement ends with, "For a life of Christ-centered service." We desire our graduates to become involved in their churches and their schools as they enter their next phase of life. Klaus and Joan are well deserving of this recognition. They have been involved at Calvin for over 35 years. All four of their children attended Calvin for their entire K-12 education. During that time, Joan was more the out front person, but Klaus was always involved as well, sometimes holding Joan back just a little bit. Joan served in elected positions as a two-time board member, where she served on the education and promotion committees, and also was many time president, vice president, all the offices in Mother's Club, now called Service Group. But Joan was involved in so many other ways as well. She helped start the Corps, was involved heavily in the Dutch Festival. She was on the 50th anniversary, all aspects of the fall plays and many spring musicals. She even decorated the new office when it was built, now 23 years ago. They were also early leaders in starting the Crusader Golf Classic. I can't remember an event at school that Klaus and Joan haven't been involved with. I could go on, but it would take a long time to share everything they have done for Calvin. They are very worthy of this recognition. Thank you, Klaus and Joan. We appreciate all you did and continue to do for Calvin Christian. I'm going to read you the award and then give it to them. It says, Lifetime Achievement Award presented to Klaus and Joan DeHaan in recognition of their Christian service to Calvin Christian School, given by the Calvin Christian Community and the School Board, June 2021. Good job. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Terry.
Thank you, Terry.
Well, first of all, we're very honored to receive this recognition, and we'd just like to thank the school board and the committee for selecting us. Calvin Christian School has been such a blessing to our entire family. We can't say enough good things about this school and about the wonderful people we've come to know here. It was a joy and a privilege to serve alongside so many other people dedicated to the mission of CCS.
We're thankful for Calvin Christian School. We've always been supportive of Christian education. My parents went to Christian school, Joan and I both did. Our children were blessed to attend here, and our grandchildren are currently enrolled in Christian schools. This is a legacy of faith well worth continuing, to live for Christ at home, church, and community. Part of the Calvin Christian School history and family, while it's an honor to be recognized, we feel we've gained much more than we've received. May God continue to bless Calvin Christian School as it flourishes in the years to come.
And to the graduating class of 2021, congratulations. May God be with you as you prepare for the next step in your life's journey. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Hello, John. So there's a great example for you. I know your parents would be so proud if that would be an award that would come to you. At this time, please join me in welcoming Mr. Brian Deist, our guidance counselor here at Calvin Christian School, who will present numerous awards to Calvin graduates. They will stand and face you as Mr. Deist reads through the awards.
Nathan Baker, Calvin Christian Certificate Award in Math, the Crusader Award, Instrumental Music Scholarship from Dort University, National Honor Society, President's Scholarship from Dort University, and the President's Education Award. Grace Bond, Achievement Gold Baylor Scholarship from Baylor University, the Baylor Choice Scholarship from Baylor University, Calvin Christian Leadership Award for the senior class, Calvin Christian Plaque Award in Humanities, Crusader Award, Event Program Participant Scholarship from Baylor University, Greg Guerin Scholarship from Greg's Goals, High School Sports Association Female Scholar Athlete, National Honor Society Scholarship Nominee, President's Education Award, and Provost Scholarship from Baylor University. Ryan Gretline, the Calvin Christian Certificate Award in Computer Studies, Calvin Christian Service Award for the senior class, Dean's Scholarship from College of Worcester, Theater Design and Technology Scholarship from College of Worcester, Theater and Dance Scholarship from College of Worcester, and the Crusader Award. Annika Gell, the Crusader Award. Megan Honig, Calvin Christian Certificate Award in Spanish and the President's Education Award. Annika Jacoby, Calvin Christian Certificate Award in Science, the Crusader Award, National Honor Society, and the President's Education Award. James Jansma, Calvin Christian Certificate Award in Social Studies, the Crusader Award, Dean's Scholarship from Gonzaga University, High School Sports Association Male Scholar Athlete, National Honor Society, and the President's Education Award. Bryn Youngiches, Calvin Christian Certificate Award in English, the Crusader Award, and the President's Education Award. Gannon Lavisa, the Crusader Award, Western Undergraduate Exchange Scholarship from Southern Utah University. Robert Lund, the Crusader Award, Honor Scholarship from Dort University, National Honor Society, President's Education Award, and the Vanderpool Memorial Scholarship from Dort University. Thomas Lund, Calvin Christian Certificate Award in Religious Studies, the Crusader Award, Instrumental Music Activity Scholarship from Dort University, National Honor Society, President's Scholarship from Dort University, President's Education Award, RU STEM Scholar Program Scholarship from Dort University, Vocal Music Activity Scholarship from Dort University. Melody Maxey, the Direct Lineal Descendant Scholarship from the Barona Band of Mission Indians, Calvin Christian Certificate Award in Art, Crusader Award, National Honor Society, President's Education Award, Salute to Education Scholarship in the Arts from the San Diego County Ford Dealers, and the 2021 Student Art Scholarship Competition Second Place Award from the Escondido Art Association. Brandon Nelson, Director Scholarship from California Baptist University. Hannah Root, the Calvin Christian Certificate Award in Music, Crusader Award, and the President's Education Award. Laulea Nala Santos, Crusader Award and the President's Education Award. William Schinkel, Bressy Scholarship from Point Loma Nazarene University. Courtney Vanderwoody, the Crusader Award. Rachel Wagenveld, the Crusader Award.
Well done, students. Testing. I'm just going to speak loud. Well done, students, and thank you, Mr. Deist, for reading those awards. Another graduation tradition is the graduating class choosing the staff member who will give the commencement address. This year, the students chose Mr. Bill Stout. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Stout.
Well, what a great day, class of 2021. I joked, I think it was with my English class, that I wasn't sure if this was an act of revenge for all the stories they had to read and writing that they had to do. But no matter the intent, I'm honored to be able to share a few thoughts, not about some of my favorite subjects of late, my tractor or my grandkids, but rather some other things that are perhaps even a little bit more momentous as you become part of the Calvin Christian diaspora. A few weeks ago, the school held its senior thesis night. At that event, our principal, David Illman, referenced our school's portrait of a graduate, which states that our graduate's identity would be formed by God's love in Christ for a life of wonder, worship, work, and wisdom. Our graduates will know who they are and what they're called to do. Well, this question of who you are is not a new question, right? In the late 70s, the Who recorded an album with the title track, Who Are You? Who? I really want to know. Tell me who. Anyway, this, not that the 70s, it was kind of cute though that there was a night that we celebrated of retro or oldies, and it was for the kids, it was the 2000s. So I'm at least going back into the 70s. In any case, nearly every action movie, the superhuman hero is asked, who are you? Denzel Washington in The Equalizer, right? Or probably any movie that he's in. Anna Kendrick asks Ben Affleck in The Accountant, who are you? We could go on with Gerard Butler, Jason Statham, Liam Neeson, Gal Gadot in Wonder Woman, as all wonder, who are you? Or the more personal question, who am I? Who can forget Jean Valjean in Les Miserables, the musical and the movie, when he finds out that another man is accused of being the convict, Jean Valjean, and in danger of being sent back to the galleys for violating his parole. He has to confront this dilemma, and he cries out, who am I? Prisoner 24601, Monsieur Madeleine, Monsieur Fauchelevent, and he famously concludes by embracing his own name and accepting the consequences. So this question of who you are is vital. It is not merely narcissistic navel-gazing. It is not an expression of shallow self-absorption. Rather, it is a fundamental existential question, one that undergirds all of our consequentlies. I believe that we're seeing in our society the sad effects of people being called to identify primarily by other things, race or ethnicity, nationality or political party, gender, sexuality, their age, their vocation or job, marital status, their body image, or their hair. In thinking a little further about this idea of knowing who you are, especially my English class, you know I'm going to ask, have you seen the movie Unbroken? I think we can learn some things from Louis Zamperini. Louis Zamperini was born in 1917 in New York to Italian immigrant parents, the second of four kids. When he was two, the family moved to Torrance, California. His status as an immigrant's kid with limited English skills made him a target, and he became a scrapper. By middle school and the start of high school, he was an outright hellion. Brawling, drinking, smoking, breaking into houses, running away from home. His older brother finally got through to him and told him he was on a deadly path. So, like any self-respecting rebel, what did he do? He joined the track team and had immediate success. Like the bulldog we will encounter later in the movie clip, he latched on with tenacity. He gave up all of his bad habits and poured himself into his new passion of running. He never lost a race his last 3 years of high school, winning the CIF state title in 1934, running 4:21. That's on a dirt track, right? None of this all-weather stuff. On a dirt track. In 1936, at the age of 19, he qualified for the U.S. Olympic team in the 5,000 meters, then tying the American record holder. To this day, he remains the youngest American to ever qualify for the Olympic Games in the 5,000 meters. In that final race in Berlin, he finished eighth with a time of 14:46, closing with a then-record final lap 56 seconds. He was the Torrance Tornado. However, World War II happened, and the Torrance Tornado became Second Lieutenant Zamperini. On a search and rescue mission, his plane went down in the Pacific Ocean. He survived the crash along with two others. They managed to find a life raft amid the wreckage and proceeded to drift in the current for 47 days from June 4 tonight till what, July 25? For 47 days, they floated until they made landfall in the Marshall Islands. Unfortunately, at that time, occupied by Japanese forces. They were immediately sent to a POW camp where Zamperini was imprisoned and brutally tortured for 2 years. One particular tormentor was Matsuhiro Watanabe, aka the Bird, who took particular delight in singling Zamperini out as the great American Olympian. This is the storyline that is the heart of the movie, which highlights Zamperini's tenacious fighting spirit. And this particular clip highlights his willpower and defiance as he glares at his tormentor. Well, as you can see, in that instance, he refused to be broken. Like the onlookers in the clip, our American pride tends to well up on us, and we collectively say, "Let's go!" Well, the camp is liberated. Zamperini returns to America, which was a shock to his family since the military had reported him as killed in action. He was celebrated as a war hero in the photo with his mom and two sisters. He eventually married and resumed a normal life. And this is where the movie and Hollywood in general gets it wrong. Zamperini's life was anything but normal. In fact, he descended into nightmares and drinking, displaying violent tendencies, what we would probably today call PTSD. He was, in fact, a broken man. So here is our first lesson about who we are. Don't believe everything Hollywood says. Now, well, that's true, but no, truly, the first lesson is we are all broken in some ways. This has crucial implications for us when we truly recognize that no matter how much inner strength we have, no matter how many athletic or academic or artistic achievements we claim, no matter what prestigious degrees or titles we hold or how much money we make, we simply cannot shake the tendency that Paul outlines in Romans when he says, "For I do not do the good I want to do, but the evil I do not want to do, this I keep on doing." We're broken. Now, if this were the end of the speech, it would be kind of depressing, right? But remember, our identity is formed by God's love in Christ. Zamperini himself experienced this, and this is outlined in the book, not the movie. After over two years of his personal chaos, he found himself one evening at a Billy Graham crusade. Eventually, he gave his life to Christ, and his life was completely turned around. And one of the most tangible and powerful byproducts of this turnaround in his life was his ability and his desire to forgive his former captors. And here is the second lesson about who we are. When seeing our identity first of all through God's love in Christ will enable us to get the right ordering of our lives and loves. It will enable us to display the kind of qualities that are outlined in your class verse, to experience a certain resilience, endurance in the face of life's difficulties, and they will come. It will enable us to walk alongside other broken people. It will enable us to put others first. And it may even enable you to offer forgiveness to others in a way that the world simply cannot understand. So, in conclusion, what would make someone like Angelina Jolie, who directed the film, offer a picture of tenderness like this towards somebody like Louis Zamperini? Do you think it was his athletic achievements, his survival of barbaric acts of torture in a World War II POW camp, his charm? Sure, that may be part of the admiration, but that's not enough. There is something about him that has captivated her, and I would argue it can still captivate the people in your world. It's an uncommon love built on an uncommon foundation of God's love for us in Christ, a love that is so great that it's capable of great character, again, as your verse says, maybe even forgiving one's enemies, something that the world finds unbelievable and may even cause them to ask you, "Who are you? Who are you?" May God bless you, class of 2021. With a life of wonder and worship and work and wisdom.
Thank you, Mr. Stout. I do have to comment that you know you're old when the 2000s are good old days. Sorry, can I get an amen? we get the pleasure of hearing from the class of 2021 valedictorian, Miss Grace Bonds, whose address will offer a beautiful preamble to the presentation of diplomas to follow. Please join me in welcoming Grace Bonds.
Welcome, parents, teachers, administrators, family, and friends, to the graduation of the class of 2021. This is an extremely proud moment for us all, and it is so satisfying to see our hard work in high school be celebrated in this way. This is also a bittersweet moment as we close the door on Calvin Christian and open a new one into our college years. The past 4 years have been nothing short of crazy, and we could not have made it through without some very important people. Our parents have endured countless mood swings, long drives to visit colleges, hungry and grumpy athletes coming home late at night, and trips to school in the middle of the day when we forgot our lunches, Thank you specifically to my mom for that one because I forgot my lunch quite a few times. All that time and effort did not go unnoticed. We also want to deeply thank the administration and board members for making this year possible and being an essential part of us standing here today. Thank you all. My fellow graduates, over the past few years, we have learned a lot of information. Mr. Marriott has taught us about the Reformation. Mr. Whitener showed us the connections between the Civil War and industrialization. Ms. B taught us how to simplify radicals and plenty more things. We've also learned a lot about our teachers themselves. We've learned that Senora Garcia cares for her students like her own kids. That Mr. Baker will stay long hours after school to help us understand a problem. And that Mrs. Lundgren's warm classroom environment can instantly lower your stress level. Although that one cinnamon candle was a little bit strong. Calvin Christian is truly a unique school where we all have felt so at home and cared for by our teachers. And for that, we want to sincerely thank you. Thank you, teachers. Do you realize how much change our class has been through? In our 4 years, we have had 2 Bible teachers, 3 music directors, 3 science teachers, 2 schedule changes, and 3 principals, just to name a few. 16 of our class started here as freshmen, which means we welcomed 9 to our class in the past 3 years. In spite of all this change, there were certain things we could always rely on. For instance, Brandon and Will's uncanny ability to get Mr. Whitener off track in class. Thomas's ability to bribe teachers with his homemade almond bars. Melody's insistence, despite Mr. Baker's disapproval, that there is no such thing as a rhombus, only diamonds. Annika's Birkenstocks, or James's love for fishing. In the play Death of a Salesman, which some of us read in AP Lit this year, Willie Loman yells at his wife as she makes his lunch for work and says, "I don't want change, I want Swiss cheese." Amusing as this sounds, Willie was saying much more than just his cheese preference. Willie was comfortable with Swiss cheese because he knew he liked it and was too scared to try something new for fear of discomfort. This is very applicable to us as soon-to-be high school graduates. We are moving into a new phase of our lives. We are leaving behind the comforts of our childhood. Many of us will be living away from home, without family and friends, and some of us doing it in a different state. Although these things seem unknown and uncomfortable, we as Christians have the comfort of knowing that we have the Creator of the universe right by our side. Deuteronomy 31, verse 8 tells us, "The Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged." And the Great Commission in Matthew 28 concludes with Jesus' promise, "I am with you always, to the end of the age." Now, this is not to say that these changes we are going to face are going to be easy, but we do know for a fact that we can step into this next phase of our lives with full confidence that the Lord will guide us each step of the way and will use us to change the world on his behalf. What is a world changer? When I think of this phrase, the first thing I think of was the glittery notebooks that I would buy in elementary school with unicorns and shooting stars all over them and big cursive letters reading, "I am a world changer." Granted, those were pretty cool when I was 7, but what does being a world changer actually mean? Being a world changer looks different for Christians than it does for the rest of the world. A world changer is someone who invents new technologies, revolutionizes the world of sports, cures a disease, or writes emotionally moving novels. But the difference for Christians is that we do it for the glory of God and the promotion of his kingdom. What are we on this earth for? We are here to bring glory to God. We can serve him in everything we do, everything from graphic design to computer engineering to skilled work in the trades, everything from medicine to sports broadcasting to writing or raising a family, and in many, many more ways. When our class comes back together for our 5 or 10 year reunion, a lot of things will have changed. How have we been successful? What will Calvin look like? how many of us got married? And how many gray hairs does Mr. Marriott have? While these things might have changed, one thing remains changeless, and that is that God will not have left our side. Despite all the change around us, his nature is unchanging and will continue to be throughout our futures. As we think of the future, let's think of an embroidery, like this one. The backside of the fabric is often a knotted mess and honestly, kind of ugly. Whenever I look at one, I always think that it's impossible that something beautiful can be on the other side. Yet time and time again, I flip it over, and there on the other side is a beautiful design. God is working in each of our lives, weaving together our different experiences and trials to form our lives into a beautiful artwork. While we may not see it, God has a plan for our future that will be fully revealed to us in heaven. John Piper sums this up. Quote, "We look at life from the backside of the tapestry. And most of the time, what we see is loose threads, tangled knots, and the like. But occasionally, God's light shines through the tapestry, and we get a glimpse of the larger design with God weaving together the darks and lights of existence." End quote. Each member of the class of 2021 is a vital thread in God's massive tapestry that is his kingdom. We can all take our individual callings and utilize the talents that we've been gifted to bring glory to his name. Instagram glamour, Silicon Valley money, and presidential power will sift through fingers like sand. But one thing will remain forever. Jesus and his eternal kingdom will remain forever, built on the solid foundation of what God has done, is doing, and will continue to do. Loud voices will try to convince us that politics or culture or the media is the main story. But the story of God and Jesus has been, is now, and forever will be the story. God is trustworthy. He has remained present and changeless in every chaos of the world through the ages. When we look at our lives and our accomplishments, it will always look like the messy side of the fabric. But because God is in control and unchanging, what he stitches will be beautiful and world-changing. I want to say a quick thank you to my class. You are all incredibly special people. Some of you I've known since we were infants, like Rachel and Robert and Thomas, and others of you I've just met this year, Nikki and Josh. But each and every one of you will be forever family to me. Who can forget Casey singing Christmas karaoke at Christmas dinner, the impromptu Beatles concert at retreat last year, cheering on our guys' football and basketball teams, getting hypnotized, and many, many more memories that we will all forever cherish in our hearts. I can't wait to see what the Lord does in our lives, and I hope we can continue to support one another. So, class of 2021, let's take this charge and dive headfirst into these new, challenging, and extremely exciting times ahead of us, so that in a world of changes, we can be world changers. And let's not forget Willie Loman. Let's embrace the change ahead of us and remember that there's a whole lot more out there than just Swiss cheese. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you, Grace. That was beautiful. So many great reminders. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present Calvin Christian School's graduating class of 2020-21. Nathan James Baker. Nathan plans on studying computer science and computer engineering at Dort University in Sioux Center, Iowa. His favorite class was AP Computer Science Principles because of the many memorable moments some that continue now, with the other three students. He enjoyed fun times with friends while participating in swimming and drama club. His favorite memories were jumping into the very cold water in the mornings and axe throwing with the drama kids. Nathan, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Grace Marie Bonds. Grace will attend Baylor University in Waco, Texas, majoring in biochemistry with a minor in political science. In AP biology, she was shown the intricacies of God's creation and gained a greater appreciation for how complexly we are made. She will never forget the friendships she made in volleyball, soccer, and the musicals. Grace is so thankful for the tight-knit community Calvin has provided. She will always cherish her time here. Grace, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Casey Simon DeYoung. Casey will study communications and journalism at Dort University. He enjoyed the interesting discussions in ethics class this year and has many fun memories with the friends from football and basketball and track and baseball. Casey would like for all of you to know that Tom Brady is the GOAT. Casey, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Diego Ruben Figueroa. Diego plans on studying finance at Point Loma Nazarene University in San Diego. He loved the fun way that U.S. history was taught and the extremely fun discussions that developed in English 12. His favorite memories include time spent on the baseball and football teams and the brotherhood that was created there. Diego, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Ryan Connor Gretlin. Ryan will attend the College of Worcester in Worcester, Ohio. He will double major with a BA in microbiology, a BA in political sciences, and a minor in environmental sciences. His favorite classes included physics honors, where he learned about so much more than classical physics, and AP literature, which showed him that some of the most memorable moments from high school can come from an English class. His roles in the fall plays provided him with great life skills, such as how to balance a wig with an axe stuck in it to impersonate a Marxist revolutionary. He is thankful for the opportunities that opened up to him while working behind the scenes in the Heritage Center, and we are grateful for that, Ryan. Ryan, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Annika Elise Gill. Nikki plans on majoring in journalism and broadcasting at either Utah State University or Sonoma State University. She loved AP Spanish, AP English, and advanced art for the amazing teachers and how the subjects helped lead her toward the career for which she is hoping. Nikki would like to thank her parents for their support throughout the years. She is proud to walk this stage with her fellow classmates and friends. Nikki, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Megan Elizabeth Honick. Megan will attend California State University, San Marcos, in the fall, majoring in arts, media, and design. She loved art classes because they highlighted her talents best. Her favorite memories include the van rides to cross-country meets and soccer games, as well as the Disneyland trip with the Star Wars Club. Calvin has been like family to Megan, and she feels blessed to have been a part of it. Megan, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Matthew Garrett Horton. Matthew plans on studying psychology at Aberystwyth University in Ceredigion, Wales. I did my best, Matthew. His favorite classes were psychology, AP English, and cultural anthropology because of the engaging topics for discussion. Matthew very much enjoyed playing ping pong in ping pong club. Matthew Calvin Christian congratulates you. Annika Wilhelmina Jacoby. Annika will major in biological sciences at University of California, Davis. AP English was one of her favorite classes because it was always fun and interesting, and because plants are evil. She loved being part of the volleyball and soccer teams because of their pregame dance parties in the locker room and the close friends she made. Annika would like to thank all of her teachers, as each of them played a very special role in who she is today. Annika Calvin Christian congratulates you. James Owen Jansma. James plans on majoring in computer science at Gonzaga University in Spokane, Washington. His favorite classes were Mr. Baker's math classes and Mr. Whitener's history classes. He enjoyed being president of the fishing club and will never forget the friendships and memories made while playing football and basketball. James would like to thank his family for putting up with him. James Calvin Christian congratulates you. Bryn Lauren Youngiches. Bryn will attend California State University San Marcos, majoring in communications. Her favorite classes included media with Mr. Butlick, psychology with Mrs. Lundgren, and AP Spanish with Senora Garcia. Cross country was the highlight of her high school experience, and she will hold the memories made close to her heart forever, like runs in the pouring rain and team dinners. She enjoyed being the junior and senior house leader for Alethes, and will look back on her time here since preschool with so much love and appreciation. Bryn, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Sean Isaac Kachi. Sean plans on studying exterior design and architecture at California State University, San Marcos. His favorite classes were economics with Mr. Whitener and study hall because they were always fun. He enjoyed going onto big track and field meets, and one of his favorite memories is finally jumping 21 feet his senior year. The friendships created on the football team and in fishing club will never be forgotten. Sean would like to thank his parents for supporting, loving, and caring for him. Sean Calvin Christian congratulates you. Gannon Kenneth Patrick Lavisa. Gannon will attend Southern Utah University in Cedar City, majoring in mechanical engineering. He most enjoyed physics class and had the opportunity to plan out and build a trebuchet medieval siege weapon. Oh my. His favorite memories include starting in center field as a freshman, seeing Ryan get waterboarded during the fall play, and being Supreme Chancellor of Star Wars Club. Gannon would like to thank his friends and for the great times had at Calvin. Gannon, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Robert James Lund. Robert plans on studying environmental science at Dort University this fall. His favorite classes were the second semester of anatomy and AP biology because of the interesting material they covered. He had the most fun ever playing and sitting the bench during soccer and track and field because of the team's encouraging and helpful attitude. Robert is thankful for the motivation and support he received from friends and teachers, especially when Mr. Whitener and Mr. Baker would conveniently schedule tests on the same day. Robert Calvin Christian congratulates you. Thomas Albert Lund. Thomas will study engineering at Dort University. AP Calculus was one of his favorite classes because of his genuine interest in the course and the fun times with Ms. B. He was captain of cross country, soccer, and track, and will always remember winning the soccer game against Tri-City at home and winning conference in the 4x4 his sophomore year. Thomas would like to thank his classmates for making high school so much fun. Thomas, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Melody Christina Maxey. Melody plans on majoring in illustration at Palomar College in San Marcos. Her favorite classes were psychology, anatomy, AP English, and independent study in art because those subjects helped to improve her artistic skills. She enjoyed playing volleyball for Calvin and liked making her teammates laugh and smile while things got tense. Melody would like to thank her teachers for putting up with her scribbles and paint strokes during their lectures. The support she's received to follow God's calling is something she will cherish forever. Melody, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Brandon David Nelson. Brandon will attend California Baptist University in Riverside studying kinesiology. All of Mr. Whitener's classes were his favorite because of how fun those classes were. He was captain of the football and basketball teams and enjoyed playing those sports each year. Brandon, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Joshua Perez Rios. Joshua plans on attending John Paul the Great Catholic University in Escondido, majoring in graphic design. His favorite classes were art with Mr. VDP and AP English with Mrs. Lundgren. These classes were not only fun, but helped him express himself in many different ways. He was a member of the surf club, and enjoyed the surf trip he was able to go on. Josh is thankful for the friendships made at Calvin in the short time he was here and feels blessed for the opportunity and experience. Josh, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Hannah Elizabeth Root. Hannah will study vocal performance and musical theater at Palomar College. She will also be singing with the Pacific Lyric Association Opera, recording a sacred music album, and competing in equestrian show jumping. She loved AP English and the deep Harkness discussions they had. Her favorite memories include playing Sharpay Evans in High School Musical, being cast as Marion Peru in The Music Man, that just is only in our imaginations. Thank you, COVID. And being president of Praise Band. Hannah is extremely grateful for Calvin and the memories made here. Hannah, Calvin Christian congratulates you. La Leonala Peralta Santos. La Leila will attend Point Loma Nazarene University studying biology. Some of her favorite classes were graphic design, anatomy, and faith expression because of the memories made with classmates. The house relay race and spring fling were her favorite highlights from the year because of the camaraderie with housemates and friends. Lalea is so grateful for the opportunity to be at Calvin and the new bonds made. Lalea, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Will Walker Schinkel. Will plans to study English at Point Loma University, Nazarene University in the fall. APUSH was his favorite class because they could mess around with Mr. Whitener. He also enjoyed Spanish 3 because that class was fun every day. Will ran cross country, played basketball, and played baseball all 4 years of high school. He'll never forget the fun van rides to games, winning his first cross country race, and his freshman season of baseball because the seniors really took him under their wing. Will, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Courtney Doreen Vanderwoody. Courtney will attend Point Loma Nazarene University to study international development. Art was her favorite class because she got to hang out with friends and have creative freedom. She was a team captain for volleyball for 2 years and enjoyed the team bonding and competition. Her favorite memories were the long tournament days when the team would spend the day together and play their hearts out. Courtney, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Rachel Ann Wagenveld. Rachel plans to attend Grand Canyon University in Phoenix, Arizona to study early childhood education and special education. Faith expression was one of her favorite stress-free classes, and she always looked forward to Mr. Seaman's awesome teaching and singing fun songs with friends. She was president of Spirit Club and is so thankful for her fellow members' creativity and the heart they poured into projects. Rachel was also on the track and field team, where she participated in shot put, long jump, and the 4x1 relay. While her 2 years at Calvin were eventful, they were also some of the best of her life. Rachel, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Hai Yang Wu, also known as Max. Max plans to study philosophy at the University of Connecticut in Mansfield. His favorite class was ethics because Mr. Marriott was very helpful and explained topics very well. He enjoyed ping pong club and playing against friends. Max, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Joshua Ray Yu. Joshua will attend University of Central Florida in Orlando, majoring in computer engineering. He loved AP Calculus because of how cool the subject is. It was his favorite math class he's ever taken. He also loved AP Computer Science principles because programming is fun and his classmates made it a great time. Joshua founded the Table Tennis Club and is proud that he had the opportunity to build something from the ground up, introducing a sport he immensely enjoys. How many have seen Joshua play ping pong? Yeah, it's a sight to see. He also actively participated in the AV Club, which appealed to his button-pushing instinct. Joshua, Calvin Christian congratulates you. Seniors, stay seated here for just a moment. It is now my pleasure to invite you to move your tassel from the right, crossing your heart to the left, becoming Calvin's newest alumni. Congratulations. Would you now please stand and please face your families? Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to present to you the graduated class of 2021. All right, you did it. Okay, that's enough. Turn around, sit down. We got stuff to do. One more thing from the class, a very special thing. Please join me in welcoming Ryan Gretlin, president of the Student Leadership Council and senior class representative, who will present the class of 2021 gift.
Wow. So every year, the graduating class chooses to donate a portion of their class funds towards some piece of our school in which they feel can be improved. This is special for two reasons. First, it allows for a more specialized look at how we can fix the small things around us. Many areas of our daily lives at Calvin are experienced more frequently and intimately by us rather than parents, teachers, or administrators. The tradition of a class gift provides an obligation for each class to contribute towards the benefit of future students. Second, this class gift serves as an example towards both ourselves and following classes, whether it be by selling donuts before school or creating a box to be auctioned off to the underclassmen. Everyone in our class has worked extraordinarily hard over the last couple of years to raise money for our class funds. And now, because of this hard work, after years of being able to enjoy and prosper through the school's facilities, we have the satisfaction of being able to contribute to these facilities for future generations. I hope that this serves as a reminder for everyone in our class to continue our divine call to represent Christ through our work and our labor by carrying on these values of appreciation and charity through college and beyond. I also hope that the current rising classes can be inspired by our fruitfulness and ethic to serve Calvin and its students through Christ. Despite numerous challenges presented to us over the last year, our class has been able to go above and beyond in fundraising. And due to this, it is both my honor and privilege to announce that our class will be presenting two gifts to Calvin as a way to say thank you for all the opportunities that have been provided to us. Our first gift is a contribution towards the equipment fund for the weight training room. When deciding what our gift should be, we contemplated all of the numerous facilities available to us at Calvin that have impacted our education and our experience. It was a tough choice. Ultimately, the weight training room has provided almost everyone in our class with lasting opportunities and enjoyable memories. We hope that this will encourage rising students to embrace those same opportunities through improved equipment. Our second contribution is a set of new tables and chairs for the Heritage Center's outdoor balcony. For those who may not know, this year has been the beginning of a new senior balcony where seniors enjoy the privilege of eating lunch out on the balcony. These lunch periods have been one of the most beneficial experiences to this class. It provided us with a time for making personal connections and enjoying each other's company. A new, better set of furniture will ensure that future classes will be able to enjoy these same opportunities without having to worry about fitting everyone around the table. Ultimately, these gifts will serve as reminders of our potential to make a difference in our communities, to further our lives as servants of Christ, and contribute towards the lives of students coming after us in order to help them, just as alumni in previous classes have done for us. And now, well, I must say, it's been an honor being your class president for the last few years. You guys have really been great. And such, as we graduate and move to different areas of the world and move away from each other, I encourage my classmates, my graduated classmates, my parents, all the parents here, faculty, and anybody else watching to continue to look for areas in your lives where you can contribute towards your community and aid others through Christ. Thank you.
Ryan, I think you've set a new standard on class gift introduction. That was so thoughtful. Thank you for doing that. And thank you, class of 2021, for your gift. In just a moment, we will start the processional after Brandon gets his hat. And the students will exit first. We want to get them outside to the plaza, followed by staff. And then we invite you all to join us on the plaza for a reception to celebrate the graduates. There are many, many, many thanks to give out, and it's always risky to start mentioning names, but many, many servants who have made the ceremony possible tonight, working behind the scenes, and so I just want to say that word as well here. Before I introduce our closing prayer, graduates, I wanted to share this verse with you. Just this morning, in time of devotions, in Romans 13, I read this verse. Clothe yourself in the presence of the Lord Jesus. I can promise this. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is present. He's always present. We're not always present to him, and in his presence you will always see more clearly everything in your life. Clothe yourself in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, it is my pleasure to welcome Dr. Michael Horton, otherwise known as Matthew's daddy, to close our ceremony and to pray for us. Dr. Horton.
I'm going to hear about the daddy later, yeah.
That's your biggest title.
It is. Let's close in prayer, shall we? Our Father, fountain of all wisdom, source of all truth and goodness, the archetype of all beauty. We give you thanks especially for communicating these gifts to these graduates here assembled. Thank you for your generosity toward them, for providing excellent instruction, more than mere information, for preparing them for a meaningful life, not just a living, and giving them rich friendships that will last through the trials and triumphs of life together. We thank you for their families and the sacrifices they've made for your children you've entrusted to their care. As they embark on this new stage, Father, we pray that you would fan the flame of wonder and discovery that has been kindled here. Above all, we pray that each graduate will know you more and more as the only ultimate source of joy, even in discouragement, pleasure in disappointment as well as success, and of grace even when they feel judged and excluded. May they cling to that word above all earthly powers over all the noise of this present age. You have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they find rest in you. Through your risen Son, by your Spirit, according to your gospel, to you with the Son and the Spirit, be all glory tonight and forevermore. In Christ's name, amen.
Graduates. Back row.